Hi everyone, I'm Francesca from Zen Journal Joy.
Today I share with you how to create this lapbook.
I use the latest digital kit from Vettore Design. The link is under this video. But first I'm going to do a quick flip through. You can also print the postcard front and back. The front is larger than the back, so it's easy to print in the right way. The only thing is be sure to print on the right side, not just only me. Cut the edges of the pages and then fold in half, and your page is done.
You can also use distress ink for the borders, so you can avoid the white, but it's optional.
Now I'm going to show you how to create these tea stain pages. Prepare 6 normal sheets of paper, a copy paper, and prepare 2 cups of black tea. Three bags are okay. Add a teaspoon of baking soda to avoid the acidity. Once the tea is cold, soak your paper in the tea. Let it dry in the sun. So now we have 6 sheets of tea stain paper, 3 normal ones, 6 special sheets of paper, linen paper, tracing paper, dots paper, baking paper, everything you like. Add 3 sketchbook paper, 3 pages from the kit, the 5 folder from the kit, and now put everything together. You can see on the screen the exact order that I use, but feel free to do whatever you want. There's no rule. You can use what you have, what you want. You can follow this tutorial step by step, or take this as an inspiration. Do absolutely what you want. Thank you. At this point, we have three groups of pages called signatures, and you can use a paperclip to hold everything together. For the cover, you can use serial boxes of Amazon boxes, whatever cardstock you have in your hand. This time I use a serial box. Open the box and use one group of pages as a template to create the cover. And then cut. As you can see, the spine is too big, and so I'll cut the cover in half and I'll add one piece on the other with glue. For this process, my favorite glue is Fabri-Tac or Flashbond. At this point, you can use also masking tape to reinforce the spine. To cover the box, you can use some backgrounds from the kit.
to add more vintage vibes, you can use distress ink for the borders. At this point, you can use backgrounds also for the inside of the cover, or you can do a mix, for example, with some fabrics that you like, or paper scraps, book pages, something like this. If you like the grungy look, you can add the fabric like this. Or in this way, if you like the traditional junk journal. You can have fun creating pockets and a collage on the inside of this junk journal. Be sure to go with the flow. Don't overthinking. Have fun and trust the process. Remember that it's only paper and you can cover everything if you don't like the final result. You can repeat without problem as many times as you want. Thank you.
At this point, we can proceed with the binding. Make a mark at 2 centimeters from the borders, top and bottom. Mark the center. Now mark 0.5 from the borders, from the edges of the spine, and the center. So you have 3 dots. Repeat for the top, the center, and the bottom. And then make the holes with the punch. Use a leftover to create a template to make the holes in the signatures. This leftover has the same height of the signatures. So fold in half and in half again. Align with the center and mark the other 2 points. Now make the holes. You can use cotton thread and a needle to sew the signatures in the spine. Start with the last signatures and from the top. Then go to the center. The bottom, and to the center again. Cut the thread. And tie a knot. Repeat this process for the other signatures. And the result is this. At this point, if you like, you can cover the spine with some fabric that you like. and you can embellish the cover with some collage or some fun elements like a little pocket, a little paper clips. Finally, you can add some gears to your journal. I'm using Glossy Accent as a strong glue, but you can use also the Flash Bond or Fabri-Tac glue. Finally, you can add a chain from a broken jewelry, for example, and then you can also use this as a great bookmark. Now it's time to create the first insert. For this one, you can use a cereal box as a base, and you can use a page from the kit as a template. Create 5 bases in this way. Cover the bases with the backgrounds from the kit, or with book pages, or with scraps. For a vintage look, you can also use the distress ink to age the edges. Now connect the bases with masking tape, and be sure to leave some space to one base to another. You can add the last base in this way. Once your base is done, you can decorate as you want. Thank you.
For the second insert, I have a plastic bag full of papers, paper scraps, and I am going to cover it with some backgrounds from the kit. For the third insert, I'm using a recycled tissue paper bag with another plastic sheet. The last one is only a cover for embellishment.
Once you have created all the inserts, you can punch the holes. Optional, you can also add some eyelets. For the cover of the lapbook, you can use another cereal box and you can use the inserts and the journal as a template. Reinforce the spine with masking tape and cover with backgrounds from the kit. Add some sari silk or another trim in this way to hold the journal. And now cover the inside with paper and fabric scraps.
This is a funny way to use the washi tape from the kit. You can create a sort of washi tape belly bands. You can embellish the spine with some vintage book page and a beautiful sari fabric. This is optional, but it adds more vintage vibes to the entire lapbook. And I love this type of style. This is super optional, but if you have some gorgeous fabric, you can add it on the cover with a clip. So this is removable, so you can use it in a second moment when you create some collage in your journal, for example. Now add the ring binder with a strong glue. I'm using glossy accent. It's great, but be sure to leave it dry for some hours. And it's done! Thank you so much for watching. Let me know in the comments what you think. And hugs from Francesca.